Hello, 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 everybody. Welcome to Vancouver, Canada. We are going to the top of a famous mountain here, Grouse Mountain. Today is December 17th, 2010. It's a lovely sunny day with a nice bright blue sky. You can see that the mountains are frozen on top. They have that snow on top, those snow-topped mountains. So we are going to have a special lesson today about different verb tenses on top of a mountain. Yeah. Hello, 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 and welcome to lovely Vancouver, Canada. We have the snow-topped mountains behind us, Rocky Mountains. We have the Cleveland Dam here, where we get our water from. It's a lovely day here. It's a sunny day. The view is stunning, breathtaking, and I want to wish you all a very happy holiday. I look forward to seeing you in the new year. We've really enjoyed making our videos, Mrs. Ford and I, who's filming this video right now. Right, Leda? Say hi! And the temperature is just perfect, just a few degrees above zero, but as you can see up top on the mountain, we've got lots of snow. So, have a great holiday and enjoy. Bye-bye.
Lesson today is a crime review. All of the verb tenses that make you feel blue, you feel blue, you feel down, cause you can't get around those tenses.
One more time.
The lesson today is a crime review. All of the verb tenses that make you feel blue, you feel blue, you feel down, cause you can't get around those tenses.
Ladies and gentlemen, PrivateEnglishPortal.com proudly presents The Present Perfect versus the Simple Past. Give it up! One action's finished, the other one lasts.
I started playing hockey at age 5. I stopped playing hockey at age 18. It's time to change. I played hockey for 13 years. Action finished. I don't play hockey anymore. I started skating at age 4. I continue skating today. Now, to show you my next verb tense example, let's return to the top of the Rocky Mountains in Vancouver, where the Winter Olympics took place earlier this year in 2010. So, although I've played hockey for 13 years, I still skate. I love skating. You know, I get a kick out of gliding across the ice on an outdoor rink atop the Rocky Mountains. Fresh air, blue sky, and Mrs. Ford by my side. But before I get off track here, my verb tense is the present perfect. So I started skating when I was 5, and I'm skating right now. So I can say I have skated for 37 years. This means I might continue skating in the future. Maybe. Steve Ford's tips. I have skated for 37 years. Point number one. Action started in the past, continues up to the present, and maybe will go on into the future. Point number two, we use for the length of time the action is done. Many students make the mistake of saying, I have skated since 37 years. Be careful. I have skated for 37 years. I have skated since a long time. I have skated for a long time. Finally, for those of you who are more advanced, I started teaching English in 1991. You can see I was wearing a shirt and tie and a poncho given to me by a Mexican student. The picture was taken at a school get-together. I taught at on-ground schools for many years. I have been teaching online since 2007. This means I started teaching English online in 2007. I continue teaching online now as you watch this lesson with me. And most certainly I will continue teaching you online in the future. This is called the present perfect continuous or progressive verb tense. I can make a strong prediction about the future and say, by 2011, I will have been teaching online for 4 years. This verb tense, the future perfect continuous, also shows that the possibility that I will continue on beyond 2011 is strong. If I'm a little less certain, I could say, by 2011, I will have taught English online for 4 years. Comparatively speaking, using the future perfect makes the possibility of the action going on into the future weaker than the future perfect continuous. That's it for me, everybody. I hope you can benefit from the examples I have shown you today. We learned a lot of English on top of Grouse Mountain here in Vancouver, Canada. Mrs. Ford and I would love to hear from you, and I hope you enjoy this bird's eye view.
Thank you.